Well, good morning. Thank you so much for being here. We are delighted that we find ourselves at Cantata Sunday like we do once a year. I have little to add this year. I will ask, as I always do, there are four movements this year. If you would please hold any applause you might be feeling you want to share till the very end so we can have a prayerful, musical, aesthetic atmosphere. I'd be most appreciative. I hope you enjoy this. This is a real, it's organized in the weeks of Advent. There's a lot of familiar carols in here. I think you're going to know almost everyone. There are no sing-along moments. We did put words up on there just so in case we sound like this sometimes, you know that we're supposed to be singing. Thank you for having us. Thank you to the choir for their considerable time and talent. And with no further ado, this is A Thrill of Hope by Joel Rainey. Thanks so much.
We begin today with a scripture from John chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. The Word was with God, and the Word was God.
Long ago, God offered a message of hope to a weary people. To those walking in darkness, God spoke of one who would bring the light of truth. To people bound by oppression, God spoke of one who would release the captives. To a world marred by sin, God spoke of one who would redeem the lost. While the people expected a mighty king or a strong warrior, God's answer resided in an infant's birth. The hope of the world was cradled in a mother's arms. Emmanuel, the one spoken of by the prophets, hailed by angels and welcomed by shepherds. Emmanuel, God with us.
Thank you.
From John chapter 1, verse 14. The Word became flesh and lived among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, full of grace and truth.
Emmanuel, God near us, God among us, God with us, but above all, God's love revealed to us. From the humblest of births, God so loved the world that the one who created us came to us to mend what had been broken and restore what had been lost. On that holy night, as angels sang of his birth, God's matchless love was unveiled for the whole world to behold. scripture from Luke 2, verses 13 to 14. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom he favors."
From the time the angels sang that first chorus to our own outpouring of song today, Christ's birth is still the ultimate hope for a broken world. At a time when God's people were looking for a warrior to overthrow a nation, God sent a savior to soften people's hearts. God's redeeming work began with a single birth on a silent night, and to the world came a heavenly peace. From Luke 2, verses 15 through 20. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them.
That holy night of long ago has forever changed our world. For those once in darkness, a new day has dawned, and new life has been given. For those worn thin by the concerns of this world, Jesus is the lasting hope of God's eternal plan. For those who grieve in the weariness of their souls, Jesus is the surpassing joy of a faithful God. For those who held captive from the rest, Jesus is the abiding peace of a new tomorrow. For any who have wandered from the path of God, Jesus' perfect love calls us home. As we celebrate this birth, we join with the companies of old in proclaiming joy. Rejoice, for a Savior has been born. Rejoice, for God is with us, now and evermore.
Thank you. as you go from this place, hear this benediction. May the love of God, the grace and peace of Jesus the Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you and those you love, now and forever. Amen. Stand and sing.